Hello, I am Xu Zhao from the PyTorch Prof Info team at Meta. Today, I'm going to talk about TorchBench and how it can be used to quantify PyTorch performance during the development loop. Machine learning benchmarking is already a crowded field, and there are plenty of machine learning benchmarks out there, such as MLPerf, DataBench, and Paper Swiss Code. You may wonder, why do we need another machine learning benchmark? This is because all the existing machine learning benchmarks have limitations, and they do not suit for benchmarking with the development of PyTorch. First, most of the existing benchmarks are end-to-end, which means they take minutes to hours to finish just one single model, therefore cannot be used for per-PR or netly performance testing. Second, existing machine learning benchmarks only cover a small number of models, or models in a specific AI field, such as computer vision. Therefore, they have limited coverage on PyTorch APIs. And finally, existing benchmarks often focus on hardware or model code instead of framework code. Some of the models in the benchmark do not even run on the PyTorch native release. Therefore, they can't be used for performance testing in the day-to-day PyTorch development. Therefore, we propose TorchBench to quantify performance in daily PyTorch development, and it has many benefits. First of all, it features very fast performance signal response tests per test, often within a few seconds. We achieve this by repeatedly running only one iteration of the model for both train and inference loop. And we prefetch the data to the device to exclude data loading. We achieve this, therefore, TorchBench provides an upper bound of any performance signal happening on the GPU computation aspect, which we believe is critical to quantify PyTorch performance. Second, TorchBench features more than 60 open source deep learning models, including all mainstream machine learning fields, such as NLP, computer vision, reinforcement learning, recommendation, image detection, and generation. Code-wise, TorchBench covers approximately 50% of overall PyTorch API surface, always real-world use cases, and we are working to push this even higher. Last but not least, TorchBench focuses on measuring performance signals from machine learning software stacks, including model code, the PyTorch framework, and underlying vendor libraries, such as CUDA. We make sure all the model tests work on the latest PyTorch native release, and it is easy to run A-B testing on different PyTorch versions, different CUDA versions, or a single PyTorch PR. Let's start using TorchBench with a simple example. First, users clone the repository and use install.py to install all the dependencies. And second, users can use the run.py utility to run a model test. In this example, we are running the ResNet 50 model inference test with batch size 512. The result returns the default matrix, which is latency. We also support a stress testing mode to keep running a test for seconds or minutes and return the throughput metric. TorchBench integrates with the PyTorch profiler utility, so it's super easy to profile a single model test. Just add the double dash profile option to your command line, and TorchBench will collect the PyTorch profiler traces, which can be easily visualized using TensorBoard. And users can manually inspect the bottleneck of the model computation. With the help of TorchBench, we are able to easily find GPU inefficiency issues within the upstream repositories, such as PyTorch, Hugging Face, and Torch Vision. And we have submitted a couple of fixes. More advanced usage of TorchBench, including collecting more advanced performance metrics using the NVIDIA DCGM. These metrics include flops, GPU peak memory usage, and GPU throughputs. NVIDIA DCGM library collects these metrics from GPU hardware counters, which are known as the most reliable way to get this information. And TorchBench also supports testing new PyTorch compiler backends on its model set. For example, it can run a model with Torch Dynamo and a specific backend, then provide performance and correctness metrics. The correctness result is the comparison between the Torch Dynamo output and the Eager Mode output. We provide a series of services based on TorchBench. First, users can specify a model or run the entire suite in their PyTorch GitHub pull requests. And our CI machine will benchmark and post the result on the PyTorch Hub's website. This can help PyTorch developers understand the performance impacts of their pull requests. Second, we run the suite every day on each PyTorch native release and prevent performance regressions. And finally, before every PyTorch release, we will run the entire suite on different platforms, such as different CUDA versions, to prevent any performance regression from sliding into production. Since the development of TorchBench workflows, we have discovered 7 performance regressions and 6 correctness errors. Correctness errors, including breaking the existing model code or causing unexpected CUDA memory leaks. Note that the false positive rate of our CI is 27%, which means the CI workflow can attribute performance to a commit, but after the manual inspection, the commit is actually irrelevant to the performance signal. We are working to further decrease the false positive rate. TorchBench is a collective work from the PyTorch Perf Info team and PyTorch Compiler team at Meta Platforms. We welcome contributions from the academia and industry to this project to make it even better. And that's all for my today's talk. Thanks everyone for watching.